Hey there, I'm Kelly Pickler.
And I'm Ben Aaron.
And we're alive.
No, we're alive.
We are alive.
No, we're alive.
We're alive on South Beach.
Because you don't want to be dead on South Beach.
Right.
Because that's just a terrible
reality.
That's never
fun.
But if you're going to die somewhere, South Beach is a wonderful place because it's shiny and the people are nice and everything's colorful.
Yes.
Hello.
I'm Dena Stewart.
And I'm Stewart.
And we're alive on South Beach.
I certainly hope so.
We went to Natpe.
And what does Natpe mean?
Okay, Natpe stands for the National Association of Television Programming Executives.
And that's a...
That's a mouthful.
Yeah, it's a big mouthful. And this is really a... industry show. It's not open to the public. People from all over the world come to South Beach
mm-hmm.
to sell contents for future TV shows that you're going to be looking at in your living rooms and bedrooms.
And it takes place at the Fontainebleau Hotel, and it's glamorous and glitzy, and unlike all other trade shows that come to the beach, and there are many, this one is different because Natpe attracts celebrities. So, obviously, it's fun to walk in the lobby of the fabulous Fontainebleau and see who you happen to run into.
And these are some of the people we ran into, and these are some of the things that they had to say.
You said that nobody knows who you are.
No one knows.
So, now who are you?
I am Jeff Goldblum. I'm an actor. I was in The Fly. And Earth Girls Are Easy was my favorite. That's where I met my wife, Gina Davis. Ex-wife, actually, now. And I play cabaret now. Jeff Goldblum.
Well, somebody's got to do it.
That's right. And I do it. I do it, doing it well, as J-Lo would say.
Let's face it, nonfiction television is fascinating in every way. You honestly can't make some of this stuff up.
The nominees have been chosen as the best in competition game shows, docu-soaps, special entertainment, documentaries, and innovation. And every one of the nominees stands out for their passion. They're constantly raising the bar and modernizing the genre with unbelievably compelling stories and personalities.
All right, good night, y'all.
Natpe is an amazing event, and you never know who you're going to meet here. And I'm talking to the greatest wife, the wife of the greatest, Muhammad Ali. And tell me, what are you doing at this event?
I love this event. This is my second visit to the Natpe at the Fontainebleau Hotel, where Muhammad Ali and I used to actually stay here at the same time Frank Sinatra was here and Elvis Presley.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like it's a monument of quality moments right in this room.
Three of the greatest icons in America.
That's right. And they were all sweet and just loving. It's going to be also portrayed in my lifetime story, autobiography. The story that has never been told, you know. And I was the backbone of Muhammad Ali. And we were a team. We were the Michelle and Obama of the 60s.
Do you live down here?
Yes. I was born and raised in Chicago. Muhammad Ali and I lived in Chicago. And I moved out here. I left Chicago maybe 5 years ago because I got older, I got colder, and I got out. So, and I'm so happy to be here. I came here to shop around for a network for my book. And
what's the name of the book?
Well, right now it's just a working title, Mrs. Muhammad Ali, The Untold Story. Oh, I just got my doctorate degree of humane letters and theology.
Congratulations,
Thank
doctor.
You. Thank you. So we're going to, I also wrote a coloring book to teach children manners and etiquette. And I do have a project called Sinbad the Peacemaker, and that's going to be my first feature film in the industry.
It gives us all something to look forward to, so thank you very much.
We're going to keep you updated on everything that I do.
Okay, and I'll keep our audience updated on everything that you do.
Thank you.
This is Ekin Gambe.
Yeah.
So, tell me, where are you from?
I'm from Istanbul, Turkey, and that's where the company is from, too. So we're coming here every market to sell our shows.
Have you done this show before?
Done Natpe? Yes, yes, we come every year.
And how does this show compare with like last year or the year before?
I mean, to us, it's a very, very important show because all the Latin American clients are here, all the North American clients are here. So it's very important that for us that we come every year. Because we are a distributor, we distribute our Turkish drama series and also entertainment formats around the globe. So for us, clients means production companies and broadcasters and all the digital platforms as well.
So this is really the place to be if you've got content that you want to sell around the world. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
And I have to say, to host this event is incredible. The 16th annual Brandon Tartikoff Legacy Awards.
People will forget what you say and they'll forget what you do, but they'll never forget how you treat them, how you make them feel. And I said, how did he make you feel? And she said, like the only person in the room. And you can't learn that. That is just who you are. And that is why we love you, Henry Winkler.
I got a medal cutting and it said, if you will it, it is not a dream. And that became the credo of my life. If you will it, it is not the dream. If you make what you feel, if you make what you like, if you make what you know, other people will come and watch it with you. I am so proud to be here to share this evening with the most extraordinary people, people who never took their eye off the ball.
In 1972, I was a 15-year-old girl watching in awe from my living room as the very first television screening of West Side Story took over my senses and the songs invaded my musical consciousness. But the actress that I could not take my eyes off of was Rita Moreno in the role of Anita, dancing, singing, and acting her butt off in this groundbreaking 10-time Oscar-winning musical film where she had won for Best Supporting Actress. Rita had no way of knowing she had already grown deep roots within my heart.
My respite was to go out on the fire escape, just like in West Side Story. The fire escape where my mom would put a blanket on. And we had a little table radio by that window, and I would turn on the music, and I listened to people like Miguelito Valdez, who was the Pharrell Williams of the time. People like that. And then I would lay back. I want you to see this on my blanket, and I would look up at the sky, and it would seem as though there were a million stars up there. And that's when I would dream my dreams.
Dream when you're feeling blue. Dream, that's the thing to do. Dream.
I'm standing here with two of South Beach local favorite people, Gloria and Emilio. How are you guys?
We're doing great. Honored to be here to honor so many amazing people in the industry, very especially our good friend Rita Moreno.
Speaking of honors, this hasn't been too shabby a year for you.
It's been a great year. We've really been blessed by everything that's happened and a lot of things coming up for this year coming.
Hello.
NAFTA is over. So, what did you think?
I tell you, I had one of the best times I've had in any of the NAFTA conferences. Everything ran smoothly, and there was a great opportunity to get in touch with a lot of the celebrities who came down to this conference, because this is an entertainment industry conference, and we're all part of the entertainment industry. So it's a great meeting place, and to the people that put NAFTA together, thank you. We had a great time, and everybody I spoke to at the event had a great time.
Even the people in the exhibition hall, you know, the people who were there to buy and sell their content, they even felt it was just a wonderful show this year.
So everybody's walking home happy, and we're all looking forward to next year. See you then.
I'm Dena Stewart.
And I'm Stewart Stewart.
And we're alive on South Beach.
I'm alive on South Beach. And my name is Henry Winkler.